This tutorial will show how to use Adobe Substance 3D Sampler and Photogrammetry to create 3D meshes with textures. Open up the software and click 3D Objects Beta, and then a new 3D model. Navigate to where the photos that you've taken of your model for Photogrammetry are located. Once you have these photos, select them and then import the photos. Substance 3D Sampler will then auto-align your photos for creation of a mesh and creation of textures. As your photos are imported, it makes sure that the photos are usable for the mesh creation. Once all your photos are imported, you can click the Submit button. You can choose Normal or High. Normal is recommended. And if you have sequentially numbered photos, you can click Sequence, so it is a little easier for Adobe Substance 3D Sampler to process your images. Then it will process the images, align them, and get ready to create the mesh visualization. This can take quite a while. After it creates the mesh visualization, you can inspect it to see what's going on with your mesh and make sure that you have all the areas covered that you need. This is the time to make sure that you have the right photos and your mesh will be usable. It's also a time that we can take things out of the background. We don't have to create a mesh of all of this. We can choose the areas that we want to create, which can be very helpful. Select the bounding box, and then you can inspect where the bounding box is, rotate it around, move and shrink the bounding box. This allows you to have a smaller mesh file later when you're ready to export, because you may not need all the different extraneous objects that are in your scene from the Photogrammetry. Take your time and go ahead and look at the different ways this can happen. If you click off, then suddenly you'll be able to see the mesh a lot better, so it can be easier to use. Once you're happy with the bounding box of your mesh, choose the resolution that you want to create the mesh out of. Here I have High, and then I'll click Submit. Then Adobe Substance 3D Sampler will process the mesh and your textures. After the mesh is generated, then you are greeted with a post-process screen. Here we can check different things about the textures, choose how big of an image we want to use for the texture, change the overall triangle count, and many other things to make our model the way we want it to be. You can see the textures, a regular material, the mesh, as well as a UV mapping of your object. Make sure you check these out to see how everything was created and if it is worth saving. Great. Remember, we can export this as a universal scene description, and we can also save it as a Substance 3D Sampler project so we can come back in and change different elements about it. If your mesh is not pointed up the right way, you can rotate it. Sometimes different 3D software packages use a different X or Y or Z as their up direction. Go ahead and change this, and you can save multiple versions, such as original and original rotated, so you can use them in your programs. Remember that when you rotate the mesh, it may actually move in its vertical direction. So go ahead and change that too, so your mesh is closer to the zero point in your 3D modeling program. To import the Photogrammetry created mesh into Blender, open up Blender and then File, Import, Universal Scene Description. Navigate to where your file is. You'll notice that there's USD files for the geometry, for the material, and then there's a general USD file that will pull all of these objects into a single file. That's the one you want to import so you have all your connected materials. But just know, in case you need something without the materials, you can import just the geometry. Hopefully this lets you dabble with Photogrammetry and Adobe Substance Sampler and create great new meshes with textures for your 3D modeling projects. Happy 3D modeling!